who is now Christopher Walken, he meets this girl in the waiting room, and she's in distress and looking for, well, she's there to see her grandmother, and her grandmother has kind of gone down. She's not herself exactly, and she's sort of on her way out, I guess, and they want to, or his brother ends up wanting to help the girl out and essentially helping the grandmother out, and by doing so, it to uplift the spirits of her, to try to, you know, prolong her stay with us and mm-hmm. and also get the girl.
What are you doing here?
We're here to spring out Lola.
What?
See, you're like a little girl who's lost her first tooth. She's stuck it under a pillow waiting for the tooth fairy to come. Unfortunately, two evil burglars have crept in your window and snatched it before she could get there. They got your tooth. Get it back.
What my brother's trying to say is we have a plan.
Right, so it's a beautiful love story, and you're a beautiful person, by the way. Beautiful blue eyes and blonde hair. And just wanted to say good luck to you in your career. We're going to watch for your film. These boots are made for walking, and I'm Tamara Henry with Real TV Films. I just want to say, believe it or not, you won the Beverly Hills Shorts Festival. You won. He won the whole thing. These boots are made for walking. You just walked. You walked all over them. You won. What's
comedy.
It like to win? Best comedy.
Yeah. Pretty hard to describe. I'm trying to get used to it myself, actually. It's our third win. We won Best Short in Myrtle Beach. And we won for Outstanding Acting at the Veneration Film Festival in Virginia as well.
All right, so you won Best Comedy at the Beverly Hills Shorts Festival.
Yeah.
And so what's coming up for you? Do you have some more festivals coming up soon?
We do have two coming up pretty soon, the Sonoma Valley Film Festival. That's coming up at the beginning of April. And then shortly after that, the Newport Beach Film Festival as well.
All right, so we're going to be watching for you. We enjoyed watching you here today on Real TV Films and In with Tamara Henry. And now we're going to change gears a little bit. We're going to take a look at another film. And this was my favorite because I love Joe Reitman. He did the movie Leo, and he's a delightful character. He couldn't be here today because he's in Costa Rica getting another gig. But we want to say hi to Leo, and now we're going to take a look at Leo. He's delightful, and his film. I mean, Joe Reitman and his film Leo. Hey, he's a lion. Take a look. This is Tamara Henry, and quiet on the set. We are rolling. This is the Beverly Hills Shorts Festival, and I'm with Real TV Films. We are celebrating here at the HollywoodBilliards.com. And let me tell you what, I'm going to give you the my favorite award tonight because I got to talk with Joe Reitman outside here before he came in, and he is delightful. He is real, talking about Real TV Films. And you get my honorary award tonight for my favorite interview.
You are very sweet. You're lovely yourself.
Thank you very much. I just wanted to hear you say that, so I thought I'd better you up a little bit. But your film is called Leo. It's 12 minutes long. It is a dark comedy.
Right.
What is it all about?
Leo is the story of a lion from Africa that comes to Los Angeles to start an acting career.
A lion?
A lion. And when he gets to Los Angeles, he realizes he might have been king of the jungle, but in L.A., he's just another guy looking for a gig.
I know. That always happens, doesn't it?
We're all lions, right? I know.
Well, you look like a lion.
That's why they... I gave the script to everybody I knew to read. And at the end of the day, everyone who read it was like, you're playing Leo. And I said, no, I'm not going to play Leo. And they were like, no. You have to play Leo.
So did you?
Yes, I'm Leo.
So you're the director and the actor?
I am.
How did that go over?
How'd it go over? Pretty well. I'm here, right?
Did you guys have a good relationship, director-actor relationship?
You know what? I hated myself as a director. I didn't like the way I worked at all. I thought I overworked me.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, I'm glad it turned out the way it did.
Okay. Well, was there anybody else involved in this film?
Yes, there's a lot of people involved. Bri Thomas Sanders is my DP. He was great.
You had to have somebody behind the camera. You couldn't be behind the camera and in front. That's a little bit hard.
It would be dumb. Yeah, and he actually went to college with me, and he's a very good filmmaker. We studied in London together, and he knew a lot about the way I act, so we were able to communicate very well, which made the shorthand easy to understand. Mm-hmm. The film was produced by Douglas Blake and Annie Duke. Inside the film are the actors Kelly Perrine, David Faustino, Krista Allen's in the longer version, but not the shorter version that's playing in the festival.
Okay, no, wait. This is starting to sound like an Oscar acceptance speech here.
I'd like to thank the Academy, Tamara, for doing such a wonderful interview.
Thank you.
Yeah, exactly. And everyone over here at Real TV Films, I'm just glad to be here.
Real TV Films.
Real TV
We're getting
films.
Credit, finally.
We're so happy to be here.
All right, now listen, I was outside talking to you, and you gave me your card, and I realized that your name, when you're Joseph Reitman, and you have this, like, Steven Spielberg story behind your name, Joseph Reitman, because I had to know, are you related to the Reitman, Jason Reitman?
Well, we'll start off by saying that you wanted my information, as opposed to me being like, here's my card, because I don't want people to think
I asked for his card.
Yes, this is not saying that Tamara, I was like, hey, Tamara, here's my card. It's not, we were talking. And at the end of the day, what happened is she said, are you related to Jason? And I said, no, but the story goes like this. When I first got to L.A., tried to meet Ivan Reitman, Jason's dad, who directed was involved in producing Ghostbusters, Animal House, tons of movies. And
you're a regular networker.
And I figured we had the same last name. We should meet.
Okay.
So what I did is I went over to Universal. I walked up to the front gate, and I said, I'd like to go meet with Ivan Reitman. And they said, who are you? And I said, Joe Reitman. And they went, oh, go right in, Joe. And I walked on the lot, and I started walking around, and a security guard says, are you lost? I said, yes. What are you looking for? I said, Ivan Reitman. He goes, oh, what's your name? I said, Joe Reitman. He's like, oh, Joe, just follow me. Brings me to the building. He goes, all right, security, this is Joe Reitman. He's looking to go for Ivan's office. They go, oh, Joe, go up to the 7th floor. I went over, walked up to the secretary, and I said, I'd like to see Ivan. She goes, who are you? I said, Joe Reitman. She goes, just one second, Joe. She goes in the other room. I'm like, this is the easiest thing I've ever done. I'm about to meet Ivan Reitman. At which point,
Thank God you didn't have a bomb.
I know. Well, it was pre-9/11. And then what happened, there was screaming going on in the other room. He leaned into her in a way I'd never heard anyone lean into anybody. And she came out red-faced, and she goes, what do you want? I'm like, to meet Ivan. And she's like, why? I'm like, because I need a job. And she goes, leave your resume. And after that point, I didn't get to meet him, so I started having friends who would go and audition for Ivan. I'd be like, just leave my headshot someplace in the office. Slide it underneath the desk, put it on the bookshelf, just leave it in the room. That went on for years, and finally I met Jason. He's like, you're the guy who always tries to break into my dad's office. And I'm like, yeah, that's me. And then we became friends, and that's
kind of... See, I told you, it's a very Steven Spielberg-ish kind of story. Yeah. Nepotism, if only by name. So we have a little hint here on how if we're having trouble breaking in, we know how to do it now.
And on top of that, Jason said he told his dad the story, and Ivan says, I don't remember that happening, but I'm sure it's true. That's what he said to me.
All right. Well, you have a fascinating story, and we're going to watch for Leo, and you are a lovely lion, sir. It's been a pleasure interviewing you.
Well, thank you, Tamara. Thank you for the interview.
And this was Tamara with Real TV Films.